Well, good morning, everyone. We're excited that you have joined us for Mercy Morning Tea, and I am super excited for our guest today, Sister Richard Mary.
Hi, Julie.
So, Sister, thank you for joining us on Mercy Morning Tea. We have our cups of coffee, so we hope that you have your drink as well. And something different that we're going to do today is not have a slideshow. Usually we have some slides that go with this, but
okay.
We want this just to be some dialogue with
great.
You and I.
Good.
We're in my office, which I know is a little echoey, so hopefully that's not distracting. But we have a beautiful setting, a beautiful window behind us.
Yes.
And it's a beautiful day. And so, Sister, as we celebrate time together, I know you have another celebration that you'd like to share with us today of what today's date is.
Great. So first of all, good morning to everyone, and I truly thank Julie for the invitation for today. And what we were speaking about today, Julie shared with me that the topic for this month was sponsorship.
Mm-hmm.
Then when she told me the date, I was excited to be the one asked to come today. Today celebrates the 26th anniversary of the establishment of the Institute of the Sisters of Mercy of the Americas. So back in 1991, this is when we did our massive reconfiguration as a congregation. I share that with you because I think sometimes in our struggles in the system
mm-hmm.
and in healthcare, we are constantly asked to reconfigure, to change.
Yeah.
And I just want to assure everyone that we are definitely following the words of our mission statement, as the Sisters of Mercy before us.
Yeah.
So in the constant evolution of reading the signs of the times and changing, we come to a new moment and a new entity. For the Sisters of Mercy, to talk about the establishment of the Institute is key today because that is the group for us as Sisters of Mercy, with you as our partners.
Mm-hmm.
This is why we sponsor in the name of mercy. The congregation of the Institute is who is our representative officially with the church. Therefore, we are their delegates. In turn, when I say we, I don't mean just the sisters. I mean all of us.
Mm-hmm.
All of us together, we are delegates of the Sisters of Mercy of the Institute. And when we get to the word sponsorship, I want you to keep in mind that the Sisters of Mercy sponsor healthcare. We co-sponsor with different groups at different times. We also recently have initiated a new foundation, and it's the Mercy Education System of the Americas. It's a new foundation that was just instituted on July 1st this month. And I'm privileged to be able to serve in the governance group with that particular new entity.
Mm-hmm.
So healthcare, education, social outreach, the Sisters of Mercy sponsor. What do we mean by sponsorship? And that's a conversation Julie and I were having.
Yeah.
So just very briefly, it's such a nebulous term, sponsorship,
mm-hmm.
but if we can think of the root word, and I'm an old English teacher, so
so
the root word, one of the Latin words is sponsere. And sponsere means to respond or to react. So in essence, when we say we sponsor, we espouse to the values
mm-hmm.
and the mission of whatever entity or group we're representing. So together as Mercy co-workers, I like to think of us as agents of sponsorship.
Mm-hmm.
So when it seems like it's far removed from us, believe me, my friends, it is not.
Right.
We are agents of sponsorship of God's mercy each and every day. And the two key ways I think each of us are called to be about this is through our presence
mm-hmm.
and through our influence. That is how we witness to the sponsorship of Mercy Health System, about the Ministry of Health Care. And I think my challenge for you today, so we were talking about, okay, so like how do we challenge each other? I think it might be to ask yourself the question, what does that look like and what does that sound like in my ministry each day?
Mm-hmm.
How do I witness that I really espouse the mission and values? What are the words I use? What are the behaviors I choose? Or the attitudes that I convey?
Mm-hmm.
And our mission statement said, as those before us. So what was it from the people before us that we'd like to continue to witness. And if we could just think about the people that have influenced us and that we would like to model, then I think mercy keeps living on. And from what my experience has been, I think mercy's alive and well.
And so, Sister, as you talk about that sense of influence and those behaviors, I know we've talked about something as simple as how we smile at each other in the hallway.
Right.
So many times as coworkers are walking from one department to another or one facility to another, we have our cell phones with us.
Right.
And we're looking down at our cell phones and we're not paying attention to anyone around us. We're just very kind of self-focused.
Yes.
And so we miss opportunities to give ministry to others, to really be that influence. So I know you talk a lot about that. Just if we could look up and have eye contact and smile and say, good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. And Julie, that is right on. And I think the other piece is that in the elevators.
Yes.
In the elevators, I don't believe we realize the missed opportunities we have. Toward each other, towards family members, sometimes it is also patients. But the eye contact, the smile, and the welcoming sense of just wishing someone a good day.
Right.
What that means, I think many of us would agree. In our culture today, if we go to the mall, we don't experience it. In service-oriented centers, where people are doing the very same thing, it's not a fault-finding about checking a cell phone or what might be coming through. It's about I'm losing an opportunity to look into the eyes of someone right here.
Right.
And for one brief moment, I get an opportunity to express and witness to the mercy of God.
Mm-hmm.
And if we could just keep remembering we are messengers of the message of God's mercy.
Yeah.
And some days we might be the only messenger that another coworker encounters.
Yeah.
Or a family member who has a loved one in ICU.
Mm-hmm.
If they cross us in the hall or we get into the elevator, they might look forlorn. And just to say, I hope you have a good day or a good afternoon. Just that is a message of God's mercy,
right,
where we can witness that we are a part of this sponsoring agency because we are agents of mercy sponsorship.
Right.
And it doesn't have to be just in governance. It's in lived out reality each day.
Yeah. So, Sister, a lot of our coworkers that watch this show, they're not in the traditional hospital setting.
Right.
But maybe they're in a cubicle. Maybe they're in a building that's even off campus. So how can they be that influence as well in the work that they do on the phone, through the computer, through their research? What would that look like?
I think sometimes, you know, I think we need to think of the real power of our voice.
Mm-hmm.
Our voice is for messaging. And messaging is not just with our vocal cords, it's our tone. It's, you know, when you're talking on the phone, sometimes people can tell you're smiling.
Right.
And they can tell, without a camera or a WebEx, they can tell. So what's my tone? What's my choice of words? How am I conveying a sense of calm to hear them? Because if you are constantly or primarily in phone ministry for your mercy ministry, you still are the main conduit.
Right.
For the witness of God's mercy. You're still an agent of sponsorship. Most people will not call us or ask to see us until they have worked through every other possibility.
Right.
So by the time they contact us, they're in a state of severe need. And so sometimes we're triggered.
Mm-hmm.
Like their anxiety becomes our anxiety.
Yeah.
So if we can just take a deep breath, remember that this is another moment that I can witness to God's mercy. Just whisper a little prayer maybe.
Yeah.
But help each other. I think another good way is just for you at your sites or in your units where you are, sometime at a coffee break or lunch, just say, what do you think might be some ways that we could just simply convey mercy to each other and just get the best practices of each other? We have the wisdom. The wisdom is alive and well in all of our coworkers.
Yes.
But we just need to stop and reflect and share what might be best practices with each other.
I love that.
Yeah.
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 And Sister, we have just a few minutes left.
Sure.
So this is a question we've kind of talked about a little bit. As co-workers as we go around and relate with each other. Perhaps those of you that are watching have heard this phrase. It's not like it was when the sisters were in charge, or it's not the same when as the sisters were around. Perhaps you're one of those coworkers who has said that, but how do you respond to those coworkers, and how can you help us have a good response to that?
Well, I thank you for the question, because
I'm here for you.
I've been doing a little reflection about this, so I'd like to give it back to each of you. What has it been like in your ministry experience when you have a change in leadership? When we have a different matrix reporting or a different group that we are reconfigured mm-hmm. with. It's kind of like the sponsorship we're celebrating today for the sisters. When we reconfigure our teams or our reporting, I like to think back to the time of Jesus. What was it like when Jesus resurrected? Mm-hmm. What did those people feel like when all they saw were the fishermen who were now the disciples?
Right.
Whatever they saw clicked in some way, because here we are 21 centuries later, mm-hmm. and we are trying to live the message of Jesus through the spirit of Catherine McCauley. And we have had the image of Jesus, but also we have had thousands of dedicated women and men, vowed religious, other lay women and men, and they have been witnesses to us. How did they inspire us? What do we want to continue? And I believe that's how we live the mission as those who have gone before us.
Yeah.
And so the sisters carry on from those who influenced them. We carry on from each other. And I can only tell you as a Mercy co-worker, so I can say this to Julie, mm-hmm. to each of you. You inspire me each and every day. Mm-hmm. By your commitment, by your zeal, by your smile, your joy, your sense of service,
yeah.
and being other-centered, that is how the Sisters of Mercy have their legacy in following Jesus, and I believe that's how we will be with each other.
I love that. Thank you so much.
Okay.
Bam, you got
okay.
it from the sister right there. Yeah, well, sister, thank you for being with us today.
Thank you, I'm honored.
And we always say, as Catherine said, resolve to be good today.
And better tomorrow.
Thank you for
Have
joining.
Have a good day.
Yep.
Okay, bye-bye.